Hello there, I'm Miki Sakuraba. Today, I'm going to be talking about Japanese ceramics. Japan has developed a rich culture of ceramics since ancient times. As a result, a large number of areas that produce ceramics can still be found widely spread throughout Japan today. In this video, I will introduce basic information about Japanese ceramic materials that were produced up until the Edo period. The English word ceramics can correspond to the Japanese word yakimono or tojiki. These are used inclusively for several types of ceramics materials. The major materials used in Japanese ceramics can be classified into four types, as shown in this table. English terminology for ceramics does not always correspond in Japanese. Here, I will introduce these four types using the original Japanese names. First is doki. Doki is low-fired earthenware without glaze. The second type is sekki. Sekki means stoneware without a glazing process. The third type is toki, which is ambiguous when translated into English. Low-fired toki, such as lacquerware, can be translated as earthenware, while higher or longer-fired toki is usually referred to as glazed stoneware. Lastly, jiki or porcelain is ultimately the purest and most advanced type of ceramic material. The definition of jiki, porcelain, is roughly the same in Japanese and English. Now, I will provide historical information about each of the four types of material. The first material is the oldest material, doki, or earthenware. The oldest type is Jomon Doki. Jomon Doki dates back more than 12,000 years, arguably the world's oldest earthenware. Doki is fired at around 800 degrees centigrade without glaze, and its shirt is porous and rough. Note the clay applique decoration of Doki that gives us a glimpse at the mystic and artistic sensibility of people in the Jomon period. The second is sekki, or stoneware. During medieval times, major kilns such as Tokoname, Atsumi, Echizen, Shigaraki, and Bizen laid the foundation for sekki production. Sekki is fired at between 12 and 1300 degrees centigrade. It possesses a non-porous and semi-waterproof shirt and exhibits natural partial glaze, which develops during the firing process. From the 16th century, late Muromachi period, sekki ware, especially bizen and shigaraki, was adapted for tea culture and praised by masters of the tea ceremony. The third material is toki. Toki, also translated as stoneware, is fired at between 1000 and 1300 degrees centigrade and glazed. There were a wide variety of toki produced in different areas, such as Koseto ware from the end of the 12th century Kamakura period, Karatsu, Satsuma, and Mino ware from the end of the 16th century Azuchi Momoyama period, and Kyoyaki ware from the 17th century Edo period. From the end of the 16th century, Raku ware was developed in Kyoto as vessels for tea by the tea master Senrikyu. Raku ware is a representative example of low-fired toki, which can be translated as glazed earthenware. The The natural texture of the clay and the brilliant color of toki were adapted for tea culture and refined by artists such as Ninsen no Nomura and Koetsu Honnami to achieve the highest artistic expression of the medium. The last material is jiki or porcelain. Jiki is composed not only of white clay, silica, and feldspar, but also of kaolin. It matures at firing temperatures of 1300 to 1400 degrees centigrade. Jiki production is the most advanced. It only started from around 1610 in Narita, the northwest part of Kyushu. It is produced in the highest temperature of the four types of materials, enabling it to form the hardest material. Imari, Nabeshima, Kutani, Seto, and Milanware are the major types of jiki. Its notable feature is its whitish body and transparency after firing when cinepotted. This is an example of the transparency of cinepotted porcelain, shown illuminated from the back. Interestingly, only porcelain was selected to be an export item to Europe among all the kinds of ceramic materials. Imari ware was exported from the middle of the 17th century into the rest of Asia and then into Europe by the Dutch. At that time, in Europe, porcelains were imported from Japan and China. Porcelain from the East was called white gold because of its beauty and rarity. At that time, porcelain was still not produced in Europe. The first porcelain production in Europe began in 1709 in Meissen, Germany, and was triggered by the impact of East Asian porcelain. Finally, I hope you enjoyed briefly learning about the major types of Japanese ceramics. I hope you have a chance to learn more about them in the future.